Good afternoon, children. Already you have learnt in the previous class letters which we cannot hear the sound. We call silent letters. You know. Already you have learnt. Now we are going to learn about homophones. Homophones. Read the following pairs of words from the lesson. K N O W N O. K N O W no. N O W no. T O 2 T W 2. These pairs of words are homophones. Do you know, children, what do you mean by homophones? Yes, homophones are words that sound the same when spoken, but they have different spellings and meanings. See here, children, they have given here two examples, K-N-O-W-N-O. These two words pronunciation same, but they have different spellings and meanings. T-O-2, T-O-O-2. Here will be the pronunciation same, but the spellings and meanings will be changed. That like some questions they have given in below. I will read the question. Listen carefully, children. Fill in the blanks using the correct homophones. Do you want dash read a book? T-O-O-2 or T-O-2? They have given here two answers in the bracket. You have to choose it, only one answer. Which one is correct? You have to write in given space. Okay? T-O-2. T-O-2. Do you want to read a book? Yes, children. You have to write here T-O-2 word. The second one is, take a dash turn from the market to reach my home. Take a dash turn from the market to reach my home. They have given here two words in the bracket, R-I-G-H-T, W-R-I-T. So you have to write the right word, R-I-G-H-T, you have to write in this place, because it will correct to, you get the correct sentence. He dashed too many cookies. He dashed too many cookies. E-I-G-H-T 8 or A-T-E-8. They have given here food picture also. You have to see the picture. Then you have to understand what they have given here. Then which we want to write. You have to write here A-T-E. He ate too many cookies. Okay, children, next one. I am feeling too dash after the illness. I am feeling too dash after the illness. W-E-A-K week, W-E-E-K week. The week meaning is 7 days. It contains 7 days we call week, but W-E-A-K week means illness. Okay? I am feeling too weak after the illness. You have to write here W-E-A-K. I bought a dash pair of socks. K-N-E-W or N-E-W. Here write N-E-W. New. I bought a new pair of socks. The last one. Can I have dash for breakfast? S-E-R-I-A-L or C-E-R-E-A-L. Can I have cereal for breakfast? You have to write here C-E-R-E-A-L. Okay, children. Afterwards, you have to once again read and write this one. Turn the page. Turn the page. Common and nature gender noun. Common and nature gender noun. What do you mean by common noun and nature noun? Common gender and nature gender. Already you have learned common noun. Common means which we call commonly. Which we call particular, it means proper. Which you call commonly means, it means common. Read the following sentence from the lesson. How he wished he had brought a friend along. They have given here friend. K color word. This is common gender noun. He pulled his jacket up over his head to help keep the rain away. They have given here in this sentence jacket. It is nature gender noun. It is a thing. In this sentence, friend is a common gender noun and jacket is a nature gender noun. A noun that refers to a person who could either be a male or a female is called common gender noun. Either be a male or female is called common gender noun. For example, teacher, it is a common. We do not take here any one teacher name. So, we call those all teacher. And doctor, also common. A noun that refers to non-living things is called nature gender noun. For example, gate, chair and sofa. Non-living things. A noun that refers to non-living things is called nature gender noun. I hope you all are understood common and nature gender noun. Next, we will go underline each noun and write it in the correct column. One has been done for you already. Common gender, nature gender. The first one sentence, they have underlined two words and they have written in common gender and nature gender also. The second one we will go. The children played with the ball. The children played with the ball. Here children and ball. See here. Children is a common. Ball is a nature. You have to write in this side children and here nature. Okay. The third one is the passenger sat in the train. In this sentence you have to underline passenger and train. The passenger means common gender noun. Train means nature gender noun. You have to write in this side passenger and here train. The fourth one is the doctor used a stethoscope to check me. The doctor used a stethoscope to check me. Here the doctor and stethoscope. Two words you have to write in this side. Doctor is a common gender. Stethoscope is a nature gender noun. The last one is my friends love to read books. My friends love to read books. Here friends and books. Friends, it means common gender nouns. Books means nature gender nouns. Okay children, things, the noun refers to non-living things are called nature gender nouns. A person who could either be male or female are called common gender noun. Okay children, next one, here using expressions to communicate here. You have to read it properly. Here are some expressions to communicate the feeling of fear. The movie was so frightening, it sent shivers down my spine. That roller coaster ride gave me goosebumps. He yelled so loud that he frightened the life out of me. Turn the page children. Next you have to come in last. Come to the last. The last one. Listen to the story and indicate whether these statements are true or false. Okay. Lola peeked out of the window. Yes. Lola peeked out of the window. Lola walked slowly towards the direction of the sound. Yes. True it is. She heard some people laughing. Yes, true. Surprise Lola. Anna and Frank yelled in delight. Yes. Frank and Lola were celebrating Lola's birthday. False. Lola is a dog. False. Okay, children. You have to write it in your textbook. Then which way send the question answer. Afterwards you have to write in your given notes properly. Okay children, bye, take care.